Welcome to Sesame Street. One of the kids in the neighborhood lost his dog and we're looking for it, you know? So, we have to find it. It's a very important mission. Here, Daisy!
Oh, where did he go? Has anybody seen my dog? Has anybody seen my dog? He's gone and left me, whoa, whoa, whoa. Why'd he ever have to go? Has anybody seen my dog?
What's the matter?
Has anybody seen my dog?
Tell me what happened.
He left me crying, whoa, whoa, whoa. Why'd he ever leave me so?
What did he look like,
He was not fancy.
No.
Collared or curled, strolling the avenue. He was a real dog.
Yeah.
Faithful and true. And he's left me boo-hoo-hoo.
Don't cry.
Has anybody seen my dog?
Oh.
Has anybody seen my dog?
Did you love him?
I loved him so much, whoa, whoa, whoa. Why'd he ever have to go?
I look for him, okay? Oh, there he is, I see your doggy. Hey, doggy,
is he my doggy?
Here he is, he's a doggy. Meow.
That's a cat.
A scat cat, I don't want a cat, I want a dog.
My poor doggy.
Oh, I think I see him. There he is, here's your doggy.
Oi, 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 oi. No, that's a pig.
A pig, go away, pig, oh, go away. Well, tell me more about him.
He was not foolish.
I didn't say he was.
Or fickle, or mean.
Yeah.
Or evil, or insincere. He hurt my feelings.
Oh.
I'm crying out loud for him, but he's not here. Does anybody see that? Anybody see my dog?
Oh, I don't know, but I'll look.
Has anybody seen my dog?
Now listen, are you sure you loved him?
Loved him so much, whoa, whoa, whoa. Why'd he ever have to
go? Okay, take it easy. I'll look for him. You stay here. Doggy! Oh, doggy! Doggy, doggy!
Oh, my poor little
I think
doggy.
I have him. Here's your doggy. Here he is. Here he is.
Oh, that's a monkey.
A monkey? That's, I don't want a monkey. I'm so embarrassed. Doggy, doggy.
Oh, my poor
here he is. Here's your doggy.
No, that's a rabbit.
A rabbit? I don't want a rabbit.
Oh,
doggy,
dear.
Doggy, doggy. Here he is. Here he is. Here's your doggy. Boop,
boop. No, that's a fish. Oh,
boy.
My poor little doggy.
I can't find your doggy. He's lost forever. Oh, no more doggy.
Oh, that's my doggy. Oh, hi, little doggy. That's my doggy.
That's a doggy?
P. Pillow. P.
Hey, kids, listen, I want you to meet a special guest from the island of Puerto Rico that came to visit us. This is Nidia Caro, and she's from our beautiful island in Puerto Rico. She's going to visit. Hey, Nidia, do you remember that La Banda, what, La Banda Dominguera?
Dominguera,
you remember that song?
I remember.
Why don't we sing it with the kids, huh?
Sure. But we have to get some instruments.
Well, yeah.
I bought some instruments from Puerto Rico.
Oh, you did?
I did. Lots
of
them. So we can form a banda.
Yeah.
A parade.
Okay, where are they? Over here?
Yeah, I'll show you.
Oh, boy, oh, boy.
Now, these are bongos.
Bongos?
Yeah. Okay, yeah, who's going to take them?
You.
Okay. And these are cymbals.
So I better take these.
Oh, because they're very big.
You take them.
Los platillos.
Yeah, okay. This is
cabasta.
It's like a maraca.
It's like a maraca.
See, it sounds like one.
Can you carry that? Kind of little. Okay. This is
El Guido.
5 seconds.
Guicharo.
El Guido. Maria, you take the Guido. This is
la lata con piedrita dentro.
This is the lata con piedrita.
Sí, lata con piedrita.
Okay, you take that. Mira. Then,
las maracas.
These are maracas.
¿Quién va a tocar las maracas?
No. Sí. Come here, I got a little triangle for you. Find a little stick. See? This is a little triangle.
El triángulo. It has three sides. That's why it's called triángulo.
That's a little one for you.
La pandereta.
Pandereta. This is a pandereta. I'm going to give you the palitos.
Clave.
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 Los palitos, como le decía yo cuando era chiquito.
When you were little, they call these palitos.
Yes, palitos, but they're called clave.
Okay. Then we've got another bigger triangle.
A bigger triangle.
Yeah. Who doesn't have a triangle?
Who wants a triangle?
Who doesn't have an instrument? You.
Oh, you give me, there's another, a bigger
There's
one.
An even bigger one.
A triangle, a bigger triangle.
This is
triangle.
A super triangle.
Super duper triangle.
You don't have one. There you are, Kelsey.
Okay.
Okay, now, let me explain. Everybody has to have an instrument for this song, and you have to play it to the rhythm, okay? And you march, because this is a song about a town square, and every Sunday, they play their instruments.
Right.
And if you're watching outside, then you just find something to bang on, and you march with us, okay? Now, everybody gets on a line, and you have to do everything
everybody
I
on
do.
A line.
Okay, like follow the leader, right? You're
too little.
The smallest
you come in the front.
First, the biggest left. I'm the last.
Okay, got a big line. Okay, you ready? Que siempre toque en la plaza con una tuba grandota y unos platillos de lata. El perro que mueve la cola, el niño pide galletas. La abuela vende bizcochos, que cura busca sus votos. Ay, el domingo en la plaza, pensar que el domingo es para descansar. Y yo que vivo buscando papeles, me voy a quejar a la municipalidad. Tengo una banda dominguera que siempre toque en la plaza con una tumba grandota y unos platillos de lata. El perro que mueve la cola, el niño pide bizcocho, la abuela vende galletas, el cura busca de voto. Ok, para mí, que viva la banda dominguera.
Hey, Ernie. Ern, hey, it's raining, you know.
Yeah, I've noticed that.
Yeah, hey, can I get under the umbrella there with you, huh?
You know how I feel, Bert? I feel so happy. I really do.
You do?
I was just thinking about all the lovely plants and flowers. We get a nice drink of cool water when it rains. And then the grass and the trees grow tall, and the flowers bloom, and it just makes me feel very, very happy.
Yeah, fine. Okay, Ernie, well, how about letting me underneath that umbrella there now, huh?
But you know how else I feel, Bert? I feel sad.
You feel sad?
I just think of all the nice people who had picnics planned for today, and now they can't have their picnics. And they had softball games. Some of them had fishing trips, and it's all ruined because of the rain. It just really just makes me feel very, very sad, Bert.
Yeah, well, okay, Ernie. How about we discuss that under the old umbrella, huh?
But you know how else I feel, Bert? I feel mad. I mean, I am really angry because I was going to take my bike to the zoo, and this was the only day I could do it, and now I won't be able to go, and I don't know when I'll get a chance again. And I'm just really mad,
that's I know
all.
What you mean, Ernie. Yeah, I know what you mean, but we can discuss that under the umbrella, right? Okay?
Isn't it interesting, Bert? Isn't it interesting that I can feel all three ways about the rain?
Oh, yeah.
Because I can feel happy about it, I can feel sad about it, and I can feel very angry about it, too.
Yeah, angry.
But what about you, Bert? How do you feel?
Wet, Ernie. I feel very, very, very wet, Ernie.
Well, of course you're wet. Where's your umbrella?
My umbrella. You have my umbrella.
Oh. Oh, gee, thanks, Bert. I'll see you around, huh?
Oh, no.
when you're a kangaroo. Living all day inside a zoo. What do you do when you're a kangaroo? And someone else's apartment is a part of you. Other animals travel a happy road. They run, they swim, they fly. But a kangaroo carries a heavy load, 'cause there's something in your pocket that you can't deny. And folks are always staring at you, me oh my. Hey, what do you do when you're a kangaroo? And you're living every lonely day as a part of the zoo. Be grateful it's not you. Who's the kangaroo? 'Cause you're never gonna worry, yeah, just what you're gonna do. Being a kangaroo, a neglected kangaroo, a lonesome kangaroo.
A piece of chain. Let's see. I bet I can make a lot of neat things with that. What can I make here? Oh, a circle. That's neat. Let's see what else I can make. Let's see. I'll make a base down there and make three corners. And I've got a triangle. Let's see what else. I bet if I make all these sides the same length and all the corners the same, I've got a square. Hey, just an old piece of chain.
Hi, look, we got yo-yos, and I'm gonna show you some yo-yo tricks. I am the yo-yo champion of Puerto Rico in 1955. Now, this is down, down, the sleeper, and up, and around the world. And now, the cradle. See? And loopy-de-loopy. Loop-de-loop, de-loop, 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 de-loop. Right? Around the world the opposite way. And the satellite. Okay? Now, let's try it. Down, up. Walk the dog, walk the dog. Wait, let me try it again. Walk the dog. Yes. Well, the dog doesn't want to walk today, but I can do the loop-de-loop. See? This is the loop-de-loop. Ta-da!
Once upon a time, in a palace in a faraway kingdom, there lived a king. And one day an awful thing happened. The king's palace caught on fire.
Help! Help! Oh, my goodness gracious me, my palace is on fire! Firemen, firemen, come quick!
Here I am, your majesty, with my trusty hose to help put out the fire.
Do it! Do it,
here I go.
Well, the firemen arrived just in the nick of time to put out the fire, and of course the king was grateful. In fact, he was so grateful, he issued a proclamation.
I now hereby proclaim that from now on, everybody in my kingdom will quit his job and become a fireman. You got that? Good.
So everybody in the whole kingdom quit their jobs and became firemen. Well, it wasn't very long before the king began having problems. For instance, one day he was playing with his erector set, and he cut his finger.
I cut my royal finger. Oh, doctor, doctor, come quick. I need someone to help me. Doctor!
I used to be a doctor, but now I'm a fireman. Maybe if I blow my siren, it'll help your finger. I hope that helped.
Oh, I hurt my royal finger and there's no one to help me. Oh, woe is me. Oh.
So there was no doctor to help fix the king's royal finger. And as if that wasn't bad enough, the next morning the king had another problem. He was waiting for his mail.
Oh, where's my royal mail? I'm expecting a royal letter. Postman, postman, where are you? Huh? Postman.
I used to be a postman, but now I'm a fireman.
But who's going to deliver my mail?
I don't know, but you want this hose?
No, I can't read a hose. Take that away. Oh, woe is me, no royal mail.
And as if that wasn't bad enough, it wasn't long before the king got hungry.
Oh, I am starved. Where's my royal cook? Royal cook, bring me my royal lunch. Where are you, royal cook? There's that bell again.
Oui, monsieur, I used to be a royal cook, but now I'm a fireman because that is what you ordered.
But I'm hungry.
Here is a fireman's hat. Would you like to eat that?
Take that hat away. No, I don't want that.
Oui, monsieur.
I'm hungry and there's no one around but firemen who give me hats. Oh, woe is me.
Well, the king was very upset and realized that he had made a mistake. So you know what? He made a new proclamation.
I hereby proclaim that everybody should go back to his old job. And from now on, only firemen should be firemen. And everybody else should just do his own thing.
Oh, fantastic. Now if you cut your royal finger, I'll be able to fix it.
And I can deliver the royal mail whenever you want it.
And I will cook the royal meals whenever you are hungry.
Whoopee!
And they all lived happily ever after because the king had learned his lesson. You see, it takes all kinds of people to make up a world, right? And if everybody had the same job, it'd be pretty hard to get along. And pretty silly, too.
Sean, what's this in my hand? A hat. Yeah, it's a hat.
A Puerto Rico.
Yes, it's from Puerto Rico, see? Farmers wear it in Puerto Rico to keep the sun out of their eyes, and they could fold it over like that and wear it. It's called a pava. A pava. What's it called? A pava. You know what? I've got some pictures of some pavas right over here we could play our game with. Okay, you gonna watch over here now? And we have a bunch of pavas on the board.
One of these things is not like the others. Which one is different? Do you know? Can you tell which thing is not like the others? And I'll tell you if it is so.
How about it, Sean? Willard? What do you think? Which one is not like the others?
I think this one goes up there.
This one?
Yeah, that one goes up. This one is not belong.
Right, I think you're right too.
Don't have two.
Yeah, why doesn't it belong? I mean, they all look the same, don't they?
Yeah.
Why doesn't that one belong there?
But they have all of them because all of these are one.
Right.
One of them, two.
Right, because in here, in this space, we have one pava, right? One pava. And here we have
two.
Two what?
Two
pava. Right, so this one doesn't belong. If I take this one off, then they're all the same, right?
Hey, hello, everybody! This is your old pal, Grover. And today, I want to talk to you about front and back. The difference between front and back. Yeah, yeah. Now, you can see that this is my front. How can you tell? Well, I will tell you. You see, you can now see my eyes, my beautiful eyes, and my handsome nose, and... Hey, wait a minute. That is not my front, that is my back. I do not want to talk about my back. It's a nice back, but I do not want to talk about it. I want to talk about my front. So, there, okay. Now we talk about my front. It is still my front because you can see my great big mouth and... Hey, that is my back again. I do not want to talk about my back. There, my front. Now, my back. Wait a minute. Okay. There, front. Back. Okay, we talk about the back then. All right. Now, you can tell that this is my back because I do not have any eyes or nose or mouth here, you see. My front. Okay, we talk about my front again. Hello, front. Back. No, my front I want to talk about. Now, my front. My back. No, front. My front is a nice... No, wait a minute. My front. Here. There's my front. No, my front. My front. Now, my back. My back. Okay, my back. My back is... No, my back. My back. My back. No, hold it. My front. No, hold it. Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Hold it. Gotcha. No. Okay. I am finished talking about front and back. Now, I will only talk about tired.
The letter P, one of my favorites. Let's see what words begin with the letter P. There's pole, and pail, and paint, and propeller. Oh, I love propellers. I used to have a lot of them when we were kids. Play around with them out there. And there's a plug. And postman. And pigeon. I hate that when they fly over like that. And parachute. And there's pepper. Hey? Let's see. P. I've got it. Parasol. How are you?
Hey, who wants to do some painting? Anybody? Oh, good. Oh, that's good. Yeah, I'll put on the smock so you don't get paint on your clothes. Uh-oh, a little trouble reaching the buttons, hmm? Hey, hold it a minute. Can you think of a better way to get those smocks buttoned up? Good. That's cooperation. David helps Kim, and then Kim helps David. Yep, that's cooperation. Let's paint.
1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4.
5.
Tickles me, I'll tell you why. Oh, there's a funny farm down the road from me where the silliest things happen that you ever did see. Play late at night when everything's dark. 5 dogs, 5 hens begin to cry. 5 cats start, 5 frogs. And this goes on to morning and the crowing of the cows.
All the good things growing better every day.
Frog here, and today I have for you a monster testing machine. See this? This is a brand new monster testing machine which we just invented. And let me show you how it works. Now, you will note that behind this plate of glass, see there is a plate of glass right here, behind this plate of glass there is a cookie. See the cookie in there? Okay, now above the cookie you'll notice there's a big mallet, right? And next to the mallet there is a water spout. See that water spout? Okay, now then, over on this part of the machine right here we have three handles. Count them. One, two, three. Okay? Now let us find out what these three handles do, shall we? Yes, we shall. Okay. Now, when I pull down handle number one, note what happens. See that? See the mallet? Yeah. Okay, I'll stop it here before the mallet ruins the cookie. You see, the mallet's going to come out there and crush that cookie into smithereens, you see? Okay, now let us look at handle number two and see what it does. Okay, we pull it down. Oops, see the water? Yeah, okay, all right, I'll stop it here. I'll stop it before the water comes out and goes running all over the cookie and ruins it terribly, you see? Okay, now let us see what happens when we pull down handle number three, okay? Here's handle number three. Aha! See that? See what's happening? The glass plate is starting to lift up, so I will let go of it here, and the glass goes back down again, okay? Now you see, handle number three is really the right handle to pull in order to get the cookie, but let us find out if the cookie monster is smart enough to figure this out for himself, shall we? Oop, here comes the cookie monster now, so I will get out of here.
Cookie! Oh boy, cookie! Cookie behind glass. Handles, one, two, three handles. Frog! Frog, go away. Me want cookie. Me figure out cookie, go away.
I'm just watching. I'm just, okay. Don't pay any attention to me. I'm just lurking here. Okay.
Cookie handles. Me see what handle number one do. Pull down number one. Oh, number one start hammer. Crush cookie. Stop that. Me pull down handle number two. What happened? Oh, water come out. Oh, stop that. Water go on cookie. Pull down handle number three. Glass come up. Stop that. Uh-huh. That's what those three handles do. Let me think. I know what Cookie Monster do now. Cookie Monster pull handle number one. Crush cookie. Oh, boy. Crush cookie. Yeah. Oh, yeah. It do crumbs. Oh, boy, boy. Hard cookie. Fresh cookie. Oh, good. Now stop that. Now pull handle number two. Water all over cookie. All over cookie. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Okay. Stop that. Handle number three. Glass go up. And up and up. Okay. Stop that. Glass stay there. And now me get cookie soup. Oh boy.
I'm bored.
So am I.
You know what I wish?
No, what?
I wish a big letter L would drop out of the sky and somebody would ask us if we'd like to hear a story about it.
Me too.
Would you like to hear a story about the letter L, boys?
What took you so long?
We thought you'd never ask.
Very well. Watch closely.
L is for leopard. That leaps in a lake and lands on a lion that wasn't awake. L is the lion chasing the leopard and lifting a log, thus scaring a shepherd.
Ah! Woo, 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 woo,
woo. L is the leopard that lies on a ledge and laughs as the lion falls on a hedge.
Well, boys, that was the story of the letter L. What did you think of it?
Interesting.
Well seasoned.
Provocative.
The question is, do you know what the moral of that story is, boys?
Yeah. Never leap on a lying leopard.
Who says
five friends can't have fun. Who says five's not as good as one? Who says two is company, five's a mob? Gotta tell you, someone who says five's too much should get a job playing basketball. Who says five's not a real great time? We think five is quite sublime. See us walk and hear us talk. We most emphatically gotta squawk about being and feeling alive and five.
Oh, come on, kitty, kitty, kitty. Come on, pussycat. Come on, kitty, 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 kitty. Come on. No, this way. Come on. Be a good pussycat. I got my own little pet pussycat. Come on, kitty, 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 kitty. Hey, Raphael!
Hey, kitty, Big kitty, Bird, how are you?
Oh, I have my new little pet pussycat. You want to see him?
Yeah.
Come on, kitty, kitty, kitty.
Well, wait. Pet? Did you say pet?
Yes, he's my pet.
Well, no, that's not a pet, because a pet has to be a live animal, Big Bird. You see, pets are called pets when they are live animals. But this is a toy, you see?
But the thing is, you know, I was thinking about it. I know you're right, but, well, I was going to get a real pussycat.
Mm-hmm.
But then I started to think about it.
Mm-hmm.
And, well, a real pussycat, well, you got to feed him.
That's right.
And you got to make sure he doesn't run out in the street where the cars go.
Right.
And you have to clean up after him.
Right.
And when I go to the farm to my granny bird to visit for a few days, well, I'd have to bring a real pussycat with me because you can't leave the poor little thing alone.
Alone, that's right.
No, and besides, it seems kind of funny that a bird would have a real cat, you know?
Oh, yeah?
So
yeah.
I have this one, and this pet pussycat never wakes me up, and he's no trouble at all. And sometimes I don't feel like playing with him. He doesn't seem to mind.
No.
And the best part is, if you pull his string, he'll follow you anywhere. Come on, pussycat. Come on, kitty, kitty. Have to turn him around. Come on, kitty, kitty. Can you straighten my leash?
Okay.
There we go. Come on, kitty, kitty. There, kitty, kitty, kitty. Come on.
See you later. You know, Big Bird is not as dumb as he looks.
Lauren, you help me count to 20, okay?
Okay.
I'm going to start first. And you help me. One.
Two.
Three.
Four.
Oh, boy. Five.
Six.
Oh, good. Seven.
Eight.
Nine.
Ten.
11.
12.
You said 12.
Yeah.
You said 12, so after 12 comes, what comes after 12?
13.
13?
14.
15?
16.
17?
18.
Oh, boy. Don't help me, don't help me. You said 18. What comes after 18?
19.
What?
19.
19?
20.
We did it.
L. Lake. What a lovely looking lake.
Thank you. The letter P, my favorite letter.
Oh, yeah? Why?
'Cause all the great food that begins with letter P. There's peanuts, pears, and popcorn. There's pickles, peppers, peas. There's pineapples and peaches and potatoes, if you please. There's pizza pie, there's pancakes, and pudding is a treat. P-p-p-p-p-p. P is my favorite letter, 'cause all those things to eat.
Well, I like letter P, too, 'cause of all the animals whose names begin with letter P. Like porcupines and pigeons, and a bird and pussycat. A panda and a parrot, and a pony you can pet. There's platypuses and penguins, a pig and a parakeet. P-p-p-p-p-p. P is my favorite letter, 'cause of the animals that I meet.
I love the letter P, because the names of my friends all begin with the letter P. Well, there's Polly, Paul, and Percy. There's Peggy and this girl. There's Patrick, that's a boy's name. And Vanilla, that's a girl. Well, there's Pamela and this Penny. There's Patty and this Pig. P is my favorite letter, 'cause of the kids living on my street.
Dressed up, all dandied and dressed up, all feathered and pressed up, and feeling so fine. Dressed up in our best formal design, outshine all the rest of you, aren't we divine? We beg your pardon, but fancy that you could be carefree and almost as happy as we see. How we're blessed with so much zest, with every button buttoned and every press pressed. We're dressed up, and aren't we the best?
Hey! Uno de estos grupos no es como los otros. Uno de estos grupos no es igual. Adivina cuál grupo no es como los otros. Y te diré si tienes razón. Bueno, aquí tenemos unos gallitos. Entonces, aquí tenemos uno, dos gallos. Aquí tenemos uno, dos gallos. Aquí tenemos uno y dos gallos. Y aquí tenemos uno, dos y tres gallos. Así que, ¿cuál grupo es diferente? Pues no más que el grupito este de tres. Porque aquí hay tres y aquí hay nada más que dos. Aquí hay dos y uno, dos y tres aquí, que si adivinaste que ese es el que es diferente, pues entonces tienes absoluta razón.
He is for puppy that plays in the park. From 10 in the morning till way after dark. He is policeman who, finding the pup, feeds him some porridge from a plate and a cup. He is for people who arrive on the scene and take home the puppy and make him all clean. P is the puppy, now safe in his bed, happily getting a pat on the head.
Hey, Bert. Hey, Bert. Let's go over to the park and play some touch football, Bert.
No, I really don't feel like it, Ernie.
Oh, come on. Don't you feel like getting out in the fresh air and passing the old pigskin around, huh, Bert?
No, not really, no.
Oh, come on. Sure, it'd do you good. 89-63-14, hike. Linebacker off to the left flank kickoff on a forward pass to victory. Hoo! What do you say, Bert, old buddy, huh? What do you say, huh?
Ernie, I do not want to go play football.
Oh, what's the matter, Bert?
Nothing's the matter.
Well, see, aren't you feeling well, Bert?
Sure, I feel fine, Ernie.
I don't know, Bert. You look kind of pale.
I do?
Yeah, your cheeks don't have that old rosy glow, you know?
They don't?
Your eyes are sort of glassy.
They are.
Sure, and your nose, there's... Look at your nose. It's kind of flabby, you know?
Well.
Look at that. Your ears look run down and your hair looks tired.
My hair looks tired? Now, that's silly, Ernie. I mean, how can hair look
arms,
tired?
Bert. Look at these arms.
What about them?
You don't have any strength in your arms anymore. They're sort of flabby and soggy-like.
Well, yeah, now leave my arms alone, Ernie. Now, come on. Boy, you a pain in the neck.
That's it. That's
what?
It, Bert.
What?
Pain in the neck. You've got a sore throat.
No, come on, Ernie.
I bet you do. Come here. Open your mouth.
What?
Open your mouth and
no,
say ah.
Wanna...
Say ah, Bert.
Ah.
Louder.
Ah.
Wider.
Ah.
Mm-hmm.
Ah.
Just as I thought.
Ah.
You got the Hungarian measles or the Hong Kong hangnails or something like that.
Oh, Ernie.
Here, come down here for a second, Bert.
Hey,
get right down here for a minute.
I'm on my knees already.
I want to put an ice bag on your head. There we go.
Ooh, that's cold. Ooh,
right.
Ooh.
That's good for your head, Bert. Now lie down.
Why lie down?
So I can put a hot water bottle on you. Come on, lie down.
Ernie, I don't want to...
Lie down right here, Bert.
Water bowl on me?
Just lie down. Nice warm
right,
hot water bottle on your tummy.
Okay. Ooh,
see?
Ooh, it's not warm, that's hot.
Sure, nice. Ooh. Warm hot bottle on your tummy there.
Ernie.
Just a second, Bert.
Look, don't be gone long.
Just a minute.
It's hot, Ernie. That's so hot.
Hold on.
Why am I doing this?
Okay.
Ernie, look.
Just a second. I want to listen to your heart.
Ernie, that's my nose.
Oh, so it is. Okay. I thought it was your heart there for a second. Back in here. Oh, there. Oh, yeah.
Well, what does it sound like?
Oh, sort of like ka-thump, ka-thump,
ka-thump, ka-thump,
ka-thump, ka-thump, ka-thump, ka-thump, ka-thump, ka-thump, ka-thump, ka-thump, ka-thump, ka-thump, ka-thump, ka-thump, ka-thump, ka-thump, ka-thump, ka-thump, ka-thump,
ka-thump, ka-thump, ka-thump, ka-thump, ka-thump, ka-thump, ka-thump, ka-thump, ka-thump, ka-thump, ka-thump, ka-thump, ka-thump, ka-thump, ka-thump, ka-thump,
It does what?
All right, enough is enough. I know what you're doing, and you know what you're doing, you know. Now, you want me to go play touch football with you, and I don't want to, but okay, Ernie. You win, Ernie. You win. I have had it. I will come and play touch football with you, so come on, let's get it over with.
Well, I don't think so, Bert.
Why?
Well, to tell you the truth, I don't feel good right now, and I think I'll go take a nap.
Alrighty. Everybody in and line up so we can count you, okay? Okay, everybody. Okay, let's get in a line. You too, Big Bird. Come on, get in line. All right, now hold still. There are 5 people. 5 people there. Now, what would happen if we took those 5 people and we mixed them all up? What would we have then? Well, let's take a look and see. Okay, there we go. Everybody's mixing up. Okay, everybody settle down again. Easy, here we go. Hold still so we can count you. Okay, there's 5. Still 5 people. Everybody mix up again. One more time. Go ahead, you can do it. Just mix up again. And we'll count you one more time. Now nobody leave and nobody else come in. Now how many do we have now? We had 5 the first time, 5 the second time. Now there's 5. Now what would happen if we took away 1 from 5? We've got 4. That's how many. Now we have 4 and we take away 1. That leaves 3. That's how many we have. Look at that. Now what would happen if we had 3 and we took away 1? We've got 2. That's how many we've got. There's just 2 left. Now, 2 take away 1 will give us how many? Do you know? Oh, there's 1. That's how many. Now here comes a hard one. What do you suppose would happen if we took away 1 from 1? Try that, Big Bird. None. That's how many.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5 apples. 5 apples take away 1 apple. Leaves 4 apples.
One, two, three, four, five.
a one, a two, a three, a four, five.
Four apples, take away one apple, leaves three apples.
Hey kids, let's see you make a triangle. Very good. Now everybody up, and let's see you make a square. Where's Benjamin? Hi, Benjamin. Come on now, Benji, you can do it. Very good. Now that's a square. Congratulations, kids.
One, two, three apples. Three apples. Take away one apple, leaves two apples.
What would happen if I stuck this balloon with this pin? That's what would happen. And if I stuck this balloon with this pin and it popped, that would scare my sister. And if I stuck this balloon with this pin and it popped, and that scared my sister, she would drop that vase she's carrying. And if I stuck this balloon with this pin and it popped, and that scared my sister, and she dropped the vase, she would tell my mother. Mommy! And if I stuck this balloon with this pin and it popped, and that scared my sister, and she dropped the vase and then told my mother would be mad.
Sally.
And if I stuck this balloon with this pin and it popped, and that scared my sister, and she dropped the vase and then told my mother, and my mother got mad, she would send me to bed without any supper. Mommy!
Sally.
And if I stuck this balloon with this pin and it popped, and that scared my sister, and she dropped the vase, and then told my mother got mad, she would send me to bed without any supper. Mommy!
Sally.
Then I'd miss the chocolate pie Mother's making for dessert. Oh, well, who wants to pop a nice balloon like this anyway?
The other way, the other way. Hey, why don't we play that game, Ambosados? You remember Ambosados?
Yeah.
Why don't we play it with the kids?
Oh, you mean that question and answer game?
Yeah, okay. Like, you see, let's play it to the kids. You get in one line over there like that.
Okay.
Right? And I get it here. And then I am the... Let's get in a line, okay. And I am the one that is looking for a helper for a job, right? And I name the job, and that's what the game is about. And then I choose one, and then we celebrate together at the end because I have found my helper in the court of Ming Chong Dang Ding. Okay, right, in the court of Sesame Street. Okay, one, ready? Ambos a dos matar y leri leri le. Ambos a dos matar y leri leron.
¿Qué quiere usted matar y leri leri le? ¿Qué quiere usted matar y leri lero?
Yo quiero un paje matar y leri leri le. Yo quiero un paje matar y leri leron.
Escójalo a su gusto matar y leri leri le. Escoja a su gusto, matar y le dile no.
Yo escojo a caridad, matar y le dile rile. Yo escojo a caridad, matar y le dile ron.
¿Qué oficio le vas a dar, matar y le dile rile? ¿Qué oficio le vas a dar, matar y le dile ron?
Le pondremos bailarina, matar y le dile rile. Le pondremos bailarina, matar y le dile ron. Celebremos todos juntos, matar y le dile rile.
Celebremos todos juntos, matar y le dile ron.
Ah, the letter P, one of my favorites. Ah, let's see what words begin with the letter P. There's pole, and pail, and paint, and propeller. Oh, I love propellers. I used to have a lot of them when we were kids, play around with them out there. And there's a plug, and postman, and pigeon. I hate that when they fly over like that. And a parachute. And there's pepper. Hey, and let's see, P. I've got it. Parasol. How are you?
One, two apples. Two apples take away one apple leaves one apple.
One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four.
Five.
Tickles me, I'll tell you why. Oh, there's a funny farm down the road from me where the silliest things happen that you ever did see. Play late at night when everything's dark. Five dogs, five hens begin to
bark.
Five cats start, five frogs
meow.
And this goes on to morning and the crowing of the cows.
That's all there is to be said.
Gonna paint a five. Let's see. Nope. Nobody home.
Number 5.
Sesame Street is a production of the Children's Television Workshop. Bye-bye.